Welcome to Excel Tips. My name is Neale Blackwood and I wanted to share with you some new and improved features of Excel. So these updates have come through in the last couple of years and I thought I'd share some of them with you. Just before we dive into some of the updates, I thought I'd share with you just how you can check your Excel current version. If you click on File and then Account, what you can do is just look at this version here. So my current version is 2307. So that's July in 23. You can try clicking on the update now option here. I think I checked yesterday and yeah, I'm still up to date. So I don't have any more updates to process, but you can check there to see if you've got any updates pending. Okay, so let's have a look at some of these new features. The first one is actually another version of Excel. So what we're looking at the moment is the standard desktop version of Excel. So this is the version that most people use. There's also a web-based version of Excel. So let's have a look at that. On the right-hand side of the screen, I've got the web-based version. So this, you need to log into your Microsoft 365 account and open up Excel from there. And you can see the Excel version that is browser-based. So because it's in a browser, you can run it on pretty much any platform. So you can run it on a tablet, a phone. You can use it through the browser. Now, a couple of things. The browser-based version does not have all of the features of the desktop, but funnily enough, Microsoft have been experimenting with it. They've been releasing some features to the web-based version before they release it to the desktop version, and we'll see a couple of those now. The web-based version allows you to access your files from anywhere. You need to save the files to OneDrive. So you may notice that I've got a couple of different cells highlighted here. So I've got this open on my desktop on the left-hand side of the screen. And on the right-hand side of the screen, I've also got the file open in the web-based version. So I can make a change in the desktop, and that will update in the web-based version. And similarly, I can go onto the web-based version and make an entry there, and that will appear in the desktop version. So the web-based version allows you to work a little bit like Google Sheets, which is Google's spreadsheet package, which allows you to share quite well. And so the web-based version has allows you to share quite well. You can even have the file open on multiple desktops. So as long as you're using OneDrive to save the file, OneDrive is Microsoft's cloud storage feature, so you can save it to OneDrive. When you have a Microsoft 365 subscription, you get storage included in that, and if you need more, you can buy more, but there's a default amount of storage included with the Microsoft 365 subscription. And so when the file's saved onto OneDrive, you can access it through multiple desktops and do sharing. And you can see where people are when they're in the file. You can both be editing it at the same time. That's the web-based version. As I mentioned, sometimes it gets features that aren't in the desktop version. They sort of test it, if you like, on the web, and then it will get updated to the desktop version. So there's two features that I'd like to share with you that are on the web-based version, but they're not on the desktop. One of them is sort of getting to the desktop, so I'll show you that. It's something that's just changed recently. The Excel dropdown. So Excel has a dropdown. You can click the entry there and we can select one of these states. One of the features that have been requested is to type a letter and then that reduces the number of options. So let's have a look at that on, I'll move out of here over there. On the web-based version, when we click the drop-down, look what happens when I press the letter N. I get New South Wales and Northern Territory showing. That has been requested for many, many years, if not 20 years, for Excel. And as you can see, it's now available on the web-based version. I tried it on the desktop version and it's got a little bit of a difference. So let's have a look here. So I click the drop down. Now, when I press the N, it shows me those entries. So the New South Wales and Northern Territory, but this shows me underneath the formula bar. So that's not bad. So that's something that's brand new. That wasn't in, when I wrote the article, that wasn't available. So that's a new feature that sort of sneaked into the desktop version. It's not exactly the same. I think I prefer the web-based version of it there. It looks like you have the ability to limit the drop-downs by typing the first letter to see that listing. Now, another feature that's on the web-based version is filtering by blanks. Now, it's not the filtering by blanks that's new, it's where the blanks are. So in Power Query, which is one of Excel's really powerful features, when you filter by blanks, the blank option is always at the top of the list. Now, unfortunately, in Excel, when you go to filter by blanks, the blanks is always at the bottom of the list. Now, if you have a lot of entries in that list, then you've got to scroll to the bottom of the filter to select blanks because it's always listed last. And again, it's been requested that that blanks option be moved to the top. And on the web-based version, there it is. So the blanks is at the top of the list. So it just saves you having to scroll down to select blanks because you might be wanting to do something with those blanks. Okay, so again, that's a feature that's on the web-based version, but it's not in the desktop version yet, but it will get here. It's just, you just have to be a bit patient, I guess. I mentioned Power Query earlier. Power Query has had a few updates recently, so let's have a look at that. So Power Query, I'll just make this wider. So Power Query can access data from a picture, which is new. So you can take a photo of something, a table of values, and you can use Power Query to import that. There's also the ability to import from PDFs now. So that's an ability that's reasonably new. So a couple of new items from Power Query. You've also got the ability to get data from Power BI. So you can have a Power BI model and you can then bring that data into Excel and work with it in Excel as well. Have that as a data source for some Excel reports. So you can do all the complex work in Power BI and then bring back the data into Excel and do some extra analysis in Excel as well. Okay, so there was something that I wanted to share with you that's relating to the Control key. Now, the Control key does a lot of shortcuts. One of the abilities of the Control key is to select different size ranges that aren't connected. So as an example, I'll show you here, you can select one range as per normal, then hold the Control key, and then you can select these other ranges. Now that's been around for many, many versions. So what's different is now you can change that selection without having to start from scratch, which is what used to happen. So let's say I do this, so I select these ranges, and I get all the way to the bottom, and I meant to include this last entry, but I didn't. Okay, so in the olden days, you would have to start from scratch to select those. But now I can hold the Control key and remove that one, and then select the range that I needed. So that's new. So you just keep holding the Control key, reselect the entry, and then you can select it again to get the exactly what you want. So just keep holding the Control key and that allows you to change the selection as well as make the selection. So that's new. Something else that's useful is the formula bar. Excel has had the ability to show you what a value equals by selecting it. And you used to press F9, but you'll notice that now the value for, in this case, C11, it only stays up for a little while. So I'll do it again. The value from C11 is showing there. So you don't need to sort of navigate to where the cell is. Obviously, we can see that value here, but if you're linked to somewhere else in the file, you can still see what that value is. It also works for functions. So if you've got a calculation there, the value it's returning is put up there as well, so you can see it. In the olden days, we used to press the F9 key, and that would show you what the value is, but then you had to remember to press escape, otherwise the value stayed there. You can still use that F9 key, I do when I'm doing training, but as you can see, this is a lot easier. You don't have to press a key or another key, it just shows you what the value is. Okay, so that's built into the formula bar now. So you just select it. The part that you select has to be sort of independently calculatable. No, it doesn't. Okay, that's it. So that's pretty good. So even if I do the X lookup, okay, so you've got to select some of it to get it there. I don't know, for example, if I select the E, that's a name, so it's got a name error. So there's a value there. So you need to select enough of it to for Excel to figure out what you want to see, but that will give you the value up the top there. Okay, so that's in the formula bar. So it helps you understand the formulas a little bit better and see what the values are. Now, something I'm gonna cover very briefly is it's in the Automate tab. And it's called Office Scripts. Now, this is a replacement for macros. So macros have been around for many, many years, and they use what's called VBA, Visual Basics for Application, as their background language. The downside with macros is you can't run them on the web. So that web version that I showed you earlier, you can't use macros on that web version. So to get around that, what Microsoft is doing is rolling out what's called Office Scripts. And that's written in a language called TypeScript, which is sort of a subset of JavaScript. And it allows you to control Excel. Now, the downside at the moment is it doesn't allow you to do very much in Excel. You can do some things, but you can't do everything. The old VBA language pretty much could control anything in Excel, but TypeScript hasn't quite got there yet. So you can still record macros, so you can record actions, and the recorder will make the code for you. So you don't need to do any coding, it does the code for you. But obviously you might need to start to edit the code. So it's very early in its development, so I'm not going to go through how you can use it. But the advantage is you can use the code on the web. So it works on the desktop and it works on the web-based version. So that's the advantage. The downside is you have to be on the internet to use it. So that's the obviously, we're all pretty much connected now, but if your internet is down, then you can't use the Office Scripts. Okay, so that's Office Scripts. It's under Automate. You can record. They've given this, I've been playing around with it. I'm still getting my head around it. Code is not as easy to read as VBA, so it's a little bit harder to get your head around, but it's new. Okay, something else that's new is the navigation pane. There's been a lot of requests over the years for Excel to have a vertical list of the tabs. We've got a horizontal list of all our sheets, but people like to see a vertical list. So under View, there is a navigation feature. And that sort of does that for you. What it does, it gives you a listing of all of the sheets. So these are the sheet names. You can open up a sheet and see the various ranges that have been used. It also has the ability to show you range names. So I've got a couple of range names created in the range name sheet. If you click on it, it shows you. So these two cells here, I've given names, so they're called range names. One's called GST, one's called workers' comp. You can use these names in formulas. That's not new, that's very old. But the fact that this is showing you where they are and you can navigate to them very quickly using the sheet name. It also, I think I've got a table in here somewhere. So the TBL states is a formatted table. That's another feature I've talked about a lot over the years. Highly recommend you look at formatted tables if you're not familiar with them. They can offer a lot of extra table functionality to Excel. So these sheets, you can see them. You can see the list there. You can open it up to see what's there. If you click on one of the ranges, it'll take you to the range. So it's a good way to sort of maybe learn or see if you've been given a file and you're trying to figure out its structure, then this can help you get your head around it. The next new feature, this is very unusual for Microsoft. We had a feature called a comment. Now, it used to look like this. So this used to be what a comment looked like. It's now been rebadged as a note. So it's like a post-it note on the cell. People use this for things like instructions or just comments about the cell. And there's a little icon that displayed. So when you pointed your mouse to it, the post-it note, if you like, would pop up. Now, that's no longer a comment. That is now called a note. So that's it there. What's now called a comment is it's a threaded comment system. You can type a comment, someone else can type a comment. Similar to social media, you can use the at symbol to mention people. You can close it off, so you have the ability to resolve the thread. So the theory is that you might have something in the cell that is maybe a formula that you're trying to get sorted out, and so people might be helping you develop the formula, and so you can put some notes there. Maybe it's describing the formula and going through what's problematic with it, and you can resolve it, or you can delete it, obviously. You can also edit it. If you do resolve it, you can unresolve it and reopen it. The theory with resolving it is that it's sort of closed, but that's unusual. Usually Microsoft will create a new name for it. Personally, I would have left the other one as comments and then called this notes, but they've decided to use comment as this threaded comment system and then rebadge the old comment as a note. So there's two different types. You can only have one type on a cell. You can't have both types, so only one at a time. And comments versus notes. This is quite useful. It's a bit more what we're used to in social media, where we can see a threaded system. So, and it puts a timestamp on there automatically, so you don't have to do that. So it's a bit more modern, if you like. And it's now the comments system. Okay, we'll finish off with the ability to see changes. So if you save a file to OneDrive, then you have the ability to track changes in there. So it's under Review, the Review tab, and it's called Show Changes. I've pretty much built this file from scratch to get ready for the video. So you can see all of my changes here, going back to when I started creating the file over an hour ago. So you can see what's changed and the selection. It tells you we've edited a drop down back there. We've got control sheet. So it gives you the list of who did it, how long ago, and what they changed. So you have to save it to OneDrive to get that ability. So that's Show Changes in the Review tab. Okay, so it's very exciting times for Excel. There's lots of new updates. Excel used to get updated once every 3 years. That happens a lot more frequently now. So keep an eye on it. As I said, I found out that the dropdown now seems to be working in the desktop. It's not perfect by any means, but just typing the N does give us these the listings here now, for example, of this dropdown, which was for states. So that is an improvement. Just a quick little thing to pick up here with the task panes on the right hand side. You've got some icons, so you can have multiple task panes visible and then switch between them by clicking these icons. The task pane is used by a lot of features in Excel, so formatting things like charts, and you can have the task panes open and then switch easily between them by just using these different icons here. Hopefully there's some useful new updates there for you. Hope you've enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching.